Hello, welcome to Mandarin Time. This is Iris.
你好，我是 Iris. 你好吗？
Today, we will continue our chapter 15. 新年就要到了。新年就要到了。Okay, so let's say today's first word. It is 阴。阴。So, if I ask you, 今天天气怎么样？今天天气怎么样? You can answer, 今天是阴天。今天是阴天。 Okay, one more time. 今天天气怎么样? 今天是阴天。好的。 How about today is a sunny day? If I ask you, 今天天气怎么样? You can answer,Yes, you can say, 今天是晴天。今天是晴天。Okay. And if 天阴了,天阴了, we put 了 at the end so we know that the weather is becoming cloudy, right? So if 天阴了, what will happen? Yeah, it's going to rain, right?So we can say, 天阴了，要下雨了。天阴了，要下雨了。So now you can see this structure, 要 together with a verb and 了. This structure is used to indicate something is going to happen. 要 something 了. And we can also use 就要something the is same, like 就要下雨了就要下雨了 And we can also use 快要 something the 快要 something the like 快要下雨了快要下雨了 And also we can use 快 something the like 快下雨了，快下雨了。 OK, let's do all these structures again. 要下雨了，要下雨了，就要下雨了，就要下雨了，快要下雨了，快要下雨了，快下雨了。快下雨了 OK, 非常好 And if 你在火车站你在火车站 Still remember 火车站 it is? Yes, train station And what will you say? Use this structure Yes, you can say 火车快要来了火车快要来了 or 火车就要来了火车就要来了 or 火车快来了火车快来了 or 火车要来了火车要来了 OK, you can use either one of all these four forms IfNext week, we will have an exam, and I want to ask you, are you ready for that? And with this structure, how could you ask? Yes, you can say, 快要考试了，你准备好了吗？快要考试了，你准备好了吗？准备 just remember it is prepare, right? And 准备好 is ready for that, right? Okay, one more time. 快要考试了，你准备好了吗？ Okay, can you use another structure? Yes, we can say 就要考试了，你准备好了吗？就要考试了。你准备好了吗? OK, 非常好。If 下个星期一是我的生日，下个星期一是我的生日，下个星期一 ，understand? Yes, it is next Monday. So if 下个星期一是我的生日 ，I can say yes. 我的生日快到了。我的生日快到了。 Okay, one more time. 我的生日快到了。 Or, 我的生日要到了。 Okay, 非常好。 If 你生病了，你生病了，要做什么？ Yes, 生病的时候，我们去医院。Right? 生病的时候我们去医院。 And 你的朋友去医院看你，你的朋友去医院看你，他会问你， Yes, 他会问你，你好点了吗？ Right? 你好点了吗？And to answer, we learned 我好多了， right? 我好多了。 And we can also say 我快好了，我快好了。 It also means I'm getting better. Okay, one more time. 你好点了吗？你好点了吗？我快好了，我快好了。 Okay, and if you are going to leave the hospital, we can say, Yes, 我快要出院了。我快要出院了。Or just, 我快出院了。我快出院了。 Okay, 非常好。Now, can you use these two words and that structure to make a sentence? The first one, 下个星期一，下个星期一。Next one, 考试，考试。So the sentence should be, Yes, we can say, 我下个星期一就要考试了。Or, 我下个星期一要考试了。 And please pay attention to this sentence. You can say there is a time in this sentence, right? 下个星期一，下个星期一 is a time phrase. So if there is a time phrase in a sentence, we can only use 就要 or 要。 We can't use 快要 and 快。 Okay? So we can only say 我下个星期一就要考试了。 Or 我下个星期一要考试了。 Okay, and let's try another one. For these two words and the structure, what sentence can you make? Yes, we can say 我下个月要去中国了。我下个月要去中国了。 Or 我下个月就要去中国了。我下个月就要去中国了。 Yes, as you can see, there is a time phrase 下个月 in this sentence, so we can only use these two structures, right? Okay, 非常好。Okay, let's say next sentence. If 你想和你的朋友七点去吃饭，你想和你的朋友七点去吃饭，现在八点了， but he doesn't come. So we can say, 都八点了，
你怎么还没来?
It means it's already 8 o'clock. Why haven't you come? Right? Okay, so in this sentence, we can see a structure. 都 something 了. It means already, and it's usually convey a complaining tone. So in that sentence, you are complaining he is late. So we say,都八点了，你怎么还没来？都八点了，你怎么还没来？ OK. And then let's try this. With these two pictures and that structure, we can say, Yes, 都九点了，快点起床吧。都九点了。快点起床吧。And you can also say, 都九点了，你怎么还不起床？都九点了，你怎么还不起床？ So in such sentences, you can feel that other people are not satisfied. They are complaining. Okay, and then last part, 汉字。So today's word is 火车站. This 火 by itself, it means fire. So you can see this character comes from a picture, right? It looks like a fire. And 车 also, the car, the vehicle, also comes from the picture. So you can see the middle one. This is a car in ancient time. So they draw the picture of this car.And then we simplified this picture to this character, 车. Okay, that's all for today. And congratulations, you have finished HSK level 2. And see you in next level.